Hello. We are now at the house of Catherine Hurwitz. She is a 9-year-old girl, goes to Grafflin School, and is very different from all of us. She's very pretty, nice, but we don't know much more about her because now we are interviewing her and will know more. I will now show you the outside grounds of her house, 201 Hamilton Road, Chappaqua, New York. This is her dog right there, Chester Hurwitz. Come here, boy. Her little bench right there, playground. And this is her well over there. It's a nice touch, don't you think? They've been doing a lot of work on their house, so it isn't exactly neat. Over here is their tennis court. Very nice to have a tennis court in your backyard, don't you think? Down there to that little blue house is their property. There's a basketball hoop, and up there is a little garage space. It's very nice because it's great for the kids, and they're putting some games up there. Follow me, please. Now, we are actually going into the house of Catherine Hurwitz. Exciting, eh? As I told you, it's not exactly neat. Come here. Garage, not neat at all, but it's not my house, so I'm not gonna be worried. Up here is a enchanted place for kids. They love to play up here. Let's take a look, shall we? In here is some storage room. Right here. Some very cool posters. Beatles. Loved them when I was in London. Snoopy loves them too. Charlie Brown. Same characters, but I love them all. Little bed, a little rusty. I love the wallpaper. Very cool. I hear the kid, Catherine Hurwitz, is having her own private club up here. But don't let anyone know I told you, because it's private. The lights are magnificent. That one's regular. Blue and red. Amazing. Shall we take a look? Pretty good for a kid, eh? Funny. Follow me. Of course, Catherine is the amazing swimmer. All her trophies is all there. Look at all these magnificent things. And of course, she went to sleepaway camp when she was 7. Still going now when she's 9. Okay. The workroom, maybe we shouldn't go in here. It's a little dusty and the playroom is very messy. Don't go in there. And the TV room. The kids love the TV now. When I was a kid, it was a privilege to watch TV. I think my kids watch this. Rocket Power. Okay, shall we go upstairs? Hey, say, why don't we go upstairs and look for the outcast? I know what I'm doing. Hello, hey Jeff. You wanna give it a go? The sister's room. I think she's so bratty, but that's just what the sister. That's just what Catherine said. And you know, sisters always fight. I had one when I was little. I had one. Okay. And now the bathroom that they redid the whole thing. She doesn't know even see she's cute. Okay, yeah, it's a tile. Real nice tile! Why don't you take a shot of the tile, man? Tile, please. Tile. Tile. The moment we've all been waiting for. At the Hurwitz's bedroom. But next, we'll be meeting. tuned after this break.
Dad, you gotta see this.
You'll find special values whether you buy or lease.
Well, we got you a new CD player.
The December to Remember sales event. Missing it would definitely spoil the surprise.
I cannot believe this!
See your New York, New Jersey, Connecticut Lexus dealer.
Is one.
On the 2000...
Continue.
There's nothing wrong with the woman.
And now, we finally get to meet the one, the only, the one, the brilliant one, the one we've all been waiting for, folks, Catherine Hurwitz. Okay, Catherine. Well, we have a few questions to ask you. What do you like to do on your spare time?
I usually like play with my friends. Well, on Mondays I go to swimming at the gym.
Yes. And on Tuesdays I go to CCW, which is like an after school. I go with my best friend. And on Thursdays I go to religion, which is like a school, a Catholic school. You learn about God and stuff. And every other Friday I have brownies, and the Fridays I don't have brownies, I have a permanent play date with Alex. And like on Saturday I have piano. Sunday it's just like free, but I usually am doing something. But like at recess I usually like play soccer, kickball, go on swings, draw with Alex, or play suicide, boxball. I do a lot of stuff at this time.
Yes.
Great. Okay, let's move on to the next. What are your best friends?
Well, I have three best friends. I have a lot of friends. Everyone's like really good friends. But I mean, my main really count on friend is Matt Auerbach, which lives on Pineapple Hill. I know him since I was in second grade. And Alex Dicon, she's a girl. In second grade, I knew her. I just really didn't like her. But now we're like best friends. Samantha Giacomo. I knew her from my other school. I moved to this school in second grade, in the middle of second grade, and I knew her from kindergarten. She's really like my good friend. Okay. I got another question. Do you do any kind of sports? Well,
team or something?
Well,
I go to a swim team, and it's really fun. We learn a lot about swimming, and I really enjoy swimming. As you've seen, I had a lot of trophies down there, but that was for the summer swimming. I never did a winter team, and now I first did it. And there's a lot of nice kids on my team. And on the weekends, I don't do a sport. I mean, I do piano, which is a sport for my fingers, but not really. And but in the spring, I start softball. And that'll be really fun. Great. Now, question is, tell us about your family. I have a little sister, her name is Julia Ann, but we call her Julie. She's six, and she has short brown hair. She has green blue eyes. And her best friend is Casey, but she's moving after Christmas. It's really sad. And also, she's in first grade. And she goes to the same school as me, and of course she lives in the same house. I have a sister, and she's 25, and she lives in Astoria. She, I see her a lot of times, but not that much. She finished college, and she has a job, and she has a video camera, and she videotapes stuff for her job. And I also have a little brother. He's four, and he lives with me also.
Okay, good. His name's Jess.
Do you play any sort of instrument? Well, I started piano when I was four, and I still do it.
Great.
I'm really good at it, and so my piano is
very good to learn.
This year, I started playing clarinet.
Wow.
And it's fun, but it's really hard.
Amazing.
I'm gonna do it with my best friend Alex.
Favorite food? Well, I like every food. There's not one food in the world that I don't like. I like bean salad, which is homemade from my mom. Always. This is the best. It's beans, good to your heart. The more you know, the more it's like. Beans, a magical fruit. The more you know, the more you too. Well, I also like California rolls. They're like wrapped in seaweed. They have rice in them, and then they have a little thing of fish. I don't know what kind or something. And a little thing of avocado. And something else that I really like.
We're all curious, and we don't know. What do your parents do for a job?
Well, my mom, she works for Aetna U.S. Healthcare, and she like writes their articles for them in their magazine, and she also does a lot with them. And I go to her work a lot.
My dad, he works in the city. He works up like almost across the street, directly across the street from Grand Central. He lives in the Lincoln Building, and he reps photographers. He helps them get the job, and then he gets the money, and he has to like talk to the people about it, and he really like gets them all their jobs.
Catherine, if you had a message to tell the whole world and the kids and the grown-ups, what would it be?
Now I want you to put your face right directly to the camera. Don't touch it, but just look right into it. Okay.
If I had a message to say to all the kids, I think it would be not to worry about things, and that things in like the world will get better, and to like not be scared. And some people are bad, but you can't assume that everyone is a bad person. You have to be nice to people and have a community. And also to give your best out and try your best for everything. And the most important thing in the world to me is my family, because they love me. And my room is important, but my family is way more important, because I love my family, and if they weren't here, I wouldn't be here interviewing.
Thank you for joining us, Catherine, and thank you for joining us at CBK News. We'll definitely be interviewing you, Catherine, again. Thank you for joining us, and have a great night.